In this video, we're looking at a projectile motion problem where the launch is perfectly horizontal. So we have a spring gun shooting a ball bearing horizontally with an unknown initial speed. And what we're given here is the height of the launch and the range for the launch. In other words, the horizontal displacement for that ball bearing during the flight. In part A, we're going to get the flight time for the projectile. And then in part B, we're going to compute that initial launch speed for the ball. So the flight time is a purely vertical question. And that's really because the flight terminates at a known value of y. At the end of this flight, we hit y equals 0, supposing that I put my origin at ground level for the problem. So we're going to write down the equation of motion for the y direction. That's y equals y naught plus v naught yt minus a 1/2 gt squared, where g is the acceleration induced by gravity. So that has a magnitude of about 9.8 meters per second squared. Now our final y coordinate here is 0. So that's gone, and our initial y velocity, that's also 0 because I had a horizontal launch at the beginning. There is no y component to that. And we can just plug our numbers in now. So my initial y position, that's the initial height of the projectile that was given to us as 1.55 meters. I put in g as approximately 9.8 meters per second squared, and t is the only unknown now. All we have to do to solve for that is subtract 1.55 from both sides, divide by the coefficient of t squared, and then square root the result. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 0.562 seconds for the flight time. In part B, we're asked to compute the initial speed of the ball, and this is a horizontal question. If I look at my x equation of motion for projectile motion, that's x equals x naught plus v naught xt, and if I suppose that my initial x position is 0, I find that my final x position is given by the initial x velocity times t. And the reason this equation is so simple is because there's no acceleration in the x direction as long as we're neglecting drag forces. Well, that initial x velocity, that's just the muzzle velocity for this spring gun, because that original launch was perfectly horizontal and it was all in the x direction. So I can plug in my final x value for the flight, that was 4.5 meters. Then I can say, well, my initial x velocity, that is the muzzle velocity for the spring gun, so that's V naught. And then the flight time of 0.562 seconds. That leaves the launch speed V naught as my only unknown. And keeping three sig figs here, I get 8.01 meters per second, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.